Lord, we worship you. Holy Ghost, we worship you. We welcome you, Lord. We welcome you, Lord. We welcome you, Lord. Hey, Galagosotaya. Holy Ghost, we welcome you. The Spirit of the Living God, we welcome you. Ragalibo Shetiria Dalagalataya. Hey, Holy Spirit, thou as well.
Power.
my Savior,
my Savior.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have welcomed our Daddy God.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
We welcome you. We give you all the praise. We give you all the glory. What a mighty Daddy you are. You are all welcome, my precious brothers and sisters, family of the Lord. I want to thank God for you being here today. God Almighty has brought us for a purpose. The love of God is great. God's love is not the same with human love. Human love is by mood. Human love is by feelings. But the love of God is by purpose. The love of God is by purpose. That is, I want to thank God for all of you that God has brought by His love. Love of God will sustain us in the mighty name of Jesus. Please continue to invite your friends, invite your family, invite all your loved ones. Let today, let the global altar be a family altar. Because the Lord wants to come to us by the Holy Ghost. He wants to come to us and reveal His Spirit to us. And the Lord will bless you in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
By the grace of God, we have this song we want to share concerning the Holy Spirit. How we should walk in the Spirit. How we should talk in the Spirit. How we should dress in the Spirit. Everything about us in the Spirit. Because we are spirits. We have a soul and we live in the body. And so the Holy Spirit is just what we need in a time like this. Join us as we sing this song. If you don't know it, I know you're going to learn it. It's very easy. Walk in the Spirit. Walk in the Spirit. Talk in the Spirit. Everything that you do, do it in the Spirit. The Holy Spirit. Pray in the Spirit. Pray in the Spirit. Sing in the Spirit. Sing in the Spirit. Oh, everything that you do, do it in the Spirit. The Holy Spirit of God. Walk in the Spirit. Zashuka Dalagayanda. Oh, talk in the spirit. Hey. Everything that you do, do it in the spirit. The Holy Spirit. Pray in the spirit. Pray in the spirit. Sing in the spirit. Sing in the spirit. Everything that you do, do it in the spirit. The Holy Spirit of God. Do not the things that are wrong in the sight of God.
In the sight of God.
But walk in the spirit and live forevermore. Walk in the spirit. Talk in the spirit. Talk in the spirit. Everything that you do, do it in the spirit. The Holy Spirit. Pray in the spirit. Pray in the spirit. Sing in the spirit. Sing in the spirit. Everything that you do, do it in the spirit. The Holy Spirit of God. One more time. Walk in the spirit. Try not to sing the song. Talk in the spirit. Everything that you do, do it in the spirit. The Holy Spirit. Pray in the spirit. Sing in the spirit. Sing in the spirit. Oh, everything that you do, do it in the spirit. The Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit of God. The Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit of God. Bow your head and say, Lord, I need the Holy Spirit. I need the Holy Spirit. Hey, Galago Soto Libra Kataya. I need the Holy Spirit. Libra Kori and the Lagalataya. Let the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost, Shakuri and the Lagaya. Lord, saturate my life, overflow. Let me overflow. Let me overflow. Let me be an overflow today, oh God. Rakalago Suna Lagaya. Refuel me, Lord. Re-energize me. Recharge me. Thank you, my Father. In Jesus' mighty name. Today we are praying. Amen. Our daddy God, we bow before you, Lord. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. Makosuka talagaya. What a mighty daddy you are. Heaven and earth adore you. Angels bow before you. Thank you, precious Redeemer, for your grace upon us. For bringing us, O Lord, to this day, Lord, we say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord God Almighty, for our walk with you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for your power at work in us. Lord, we are grateful. Lord, we are grateful. It is by your grace that we are here. Lord, we give you all the praise in the name of Jesus. Lord, we hand over, O God Almighty, this prayer retreat into your hands, O Lord. We have come to pray, Lord. We have come to receive strength. We have come to renew strength. We have come, oh God, that you will rub off on us, oh God. You will embrace us, oh God. Lord, have your way, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for your son over there. Thank you for your daughter over there. Thank you for that, for our mommy there. Our daddy is there. Lord, our grandma is over there. Thank you, Lord, for the minister that is there. Lord, gather all of us together. Look at that gospel singer. Today, oh God, you want to do something peculiar, something unique in our lives, oh God. None of us will miss it in the name of Jesus. Cover the whole atmosphere with the blood of Jesus. Cover the airwaves, the networks with the blood of Jesus. We receive favor before you and before men. We bless, oh Lord, the owners of Facebook. We say, Father God Almighty, that we favor your work today in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, sweet Heavenly Father. We love you, we love you, we love you. We love you, we love you, we love you. Lord God Almighty, we pray the Lord for adventure. During this broadcast, the trumpet shall sound. Lord, count all of us, Lord, and our family members worthy to reign with you in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, sweet dad. Glory be to your holy name. In Jesus' unchallengeable mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. I left somebody that has the Holy Ghost there shouting loud, amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Once again, you are welcome in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
By the grace of God, we have the word of God before us. We want to pray the mind of God. Beloved, all the books you know in this life, they went through editing. The only book that did not go through editing is the Bible. The Bible says in the book of 2 Peter chapter 1 verses 19 to 21. The Bible says it is a sure word of prophecy.
Yes, sir.
It was not edited. God's word cannot be edited. The word is forever settled in heaven.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So your Jesus books were edited.
Yes, sir.
Your pastor's books were edited.
Yes, sir.
But this particular book was never edited.
Hallelujah.
That's why we believe this word.
Yes.
And we will stand with this word. Just read verse 19, son.
We have also a sure word of prophecy.
The Bible says we have also a sure. Somebody say sure.
Sure.
A sure word of prophecy. Yes.
We are unto ye do well.
Yes, we do well.
That ye take heed.
The Bible says take heed to this
as
world.
As unto a light.
There's no mistake in this
that
world.
That shineth in a dark place.
It is a light that shines in a dark place.
Until the day dawn.
Until the day dawn.
And the day star arise in our hearts.
Until God begins to manifest in our lives, we cannot stop the world. We will continue with the word until we see his face at last.
Amen.
Say, I will not joke with the sure word of prophecy.
I will not joke with the sure word of prophecy.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Beloved, today the Lord God Almighty has come to us to declare that he wants to teach us about himself.
Mm.
He wants to teach us about his spirit. He wants to talk about the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
What is the Holy Spirit? Who is the Holy Spirit? Rakoni Bakasanda. We will know today in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The topic of today's message is a question. The Lord is saying, which ghost is in you?
Yeah.
He said, if you say it is the Holy Ghost, have you cross-checked whether the Holy Ghost is still in you? Because there are many ghosts. There are many ghosts. The Lord said, the Holy Spirit is my spirit. Everybody has spirit. God is holy, and so his spirit is Holy Spirit. Why? Because we have evil spirit, we have the human spirit. Like I have the human spirit. It is the human spirit that gets born again. And so God said that we should know today that the Holy Spirit is his spirit. It is him that is holy, that is a spirit. It's not a person like we have been taught. The Holy Spirit is not a different entity like we have been taught. We are starting with illustration today. We have been taught that God is three. I can never worship three gods. I will be confused. I will know when this one is happy and when this one is sad. I will not never be confused. We are worshiping one God. The Bible says in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 6 verse 4. It says, hear, O church.
Hear, O Israel.
Hear, O church. Hear, O Israel. The Lord our God
is one Lord.
Is one
Lord.
And God said, I will never change to three.
That's true.
God said, I am the Father. And I entered. This is what they taught us. They say God the Father,
God
is one, and they call it Trinity.
Oh, yeah.
That is why you see other religions, they don't respect Christians. They think we are serving three gods. God said, I am one. Throw away. God said, this is me. I entered a son when I wanted to redeem my people. I look for a family that is favored, and I wanted a family of Mary. Her mother's name is Anne. I've been to their house when I went to Israel. He went to the house of Mary and said, I've seen a favored virgin. There were many virgins in Israel. Not only Mary, there were so many virgins. Because everybody knew the prophecy that a virgin would conceive. And every mother was preserving their daughters to be that virgin. That is why the angel came and said, hail Mary, you are favored, highly favored. Among all the virgins I chose you, fire. God said, I look for a vessel, I look for a pure girl, and I entered into her. The Holy Ghost incubated me. I am one God, and my spirit is the Holy Spirit. There is no three. I am not three. When people don't understand things, they go and use their brain. We are not permitted to use literal interpretation for the Bible. The Bible says, yeah, do eh.
Not knowing
the scripture, not the power of God. When people do not understand God, they form God. They make out what they feel about God. God was not born. God has no mother. God has no baby. He said, I entered into man the same way he has. He compressed his spirit and entered into man. God said, I am one God. And my spirit is what I put inside of my children. Go to the book of John chapter 3, verses 3 to 5.
Yes.
John chapter 3, verses 3 to 5. It is established that
John
is
chapter three,
one God, yes.
3 to 5.
Yes, sir.
Jesus answered and said unto him,
The man called Nicodemus came to Jesus to ask him about how can I be saved? Yes.
Verily, verily, I say unto thee.
Jesus answered and said, Verily, verily, I say unto thee.
Except a man be born again.
Except a man be born again.
He cannot see the kingdom of God.
He cannot see. The kingdom of God. He cannot see. Go ahead.
Nicodemus said unto him.
Nicodemus began to wonder because he is using natural mind. Because the natural mind cannot understand the things of that spirit. He began to use natural mind. He said,
How can a man be born?
How can a man, because he was over 70 years. How can a man be born when he is old?
Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb?
Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb?
And be born. Jesus answered.
Jesus did not shun him. Did he make mockery of him? The reason why many Christians we are suffering, we don't ask him questions. If you ask Jesus question, he will answer you. This Jesus you are talking about here is the Mary's baby. He came with the Spirit of God in him as God. But he had flesh and blood. Why? A spirit cannot die for flesh and blood. Spirits don't die. God needed flesh and blood because without the shedding of blood, there's no remission of sin. And God needed a blood to combine with his spirit. Like a to redeem me and you. So this Jesus here is the Jesus that was born by flesh and blood. The Bible says, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, Jesus answered,
Except a man be born of water
and of the Spirit,
he cannot enter.
Many people are still seeing the kingdom, be born again. They have not been born of the water. They have not been born of the literal water of baptism. They have not been born of the water of the word. They have not been born by God. That is why they don't resemble God. Because there is no way a goat can give birth to a chicken. The Bible says God must see himself in a human being before they can enter heaven. Heaven is not by born again. Just born again is that you are seeing. You are just looking. You are seeing the kingdom, but you cannot enter. Until you are born, what read it again? Of water.
And of the Spirit.
Born of water. You must go into water and come up. Die and resurrect. Not by sprinkling. You must go into the water and be immersed. In the name of Jesus Christ. You must be born of the water of the word. And then of the spirit. God must give birth to you. God's spirit must enter into me and you for us to enter heaven. Nobody is entering heaven without the Spirit of God. The Spirit of God in the heart of man is what makes us to enter heaven.
That's right.
Unless that condition, nobody can enter heaven. That is why Jesus did not joke with the Holy Ghost. He prepared his disciples. He went to them in the book of Luke chapter 24, verse number 49. Luke 24, verse 49. He finished after addressing them
getting ready to ascend, the Bible says, yes.
Luke chapter 24, verse 49.
Verse 49.
And behold, I send the promise of my Father
Jesus
upon you.
Jesus said, I am sending the promise of the Father upon you. It's a promise.
For 30 years in the city of Jerusalem.
But go and wait for me in Jerusalem. Go and wait for me.
Until you be endued with power.
Wait on. Until, somebody say until.
Until.
Wait on.
Until.
It's not by pastor forcing it. It's not by counting 1, 2, 3. It's not by saying, get ready as I throw my jacket, the Holy Ghost is coming. The Bible says, starry ye until.
You be endued with power from on high.
Until the pastor's heart touches.
Until you be endued.
Until the body only for him.
Until you be endued.
Until you be endued.
With,
by who?
With power.
With power.
From on high.
From the church altar.
From on high.
From the GO.
From on high.
This outpouring of the power of God is coming from on high. It's not monitored by man. It's only the power of man. It's coming from above. God said, Jesus told them, go and wait for me. Go and tarry. But there is a reason why you must have my spirit in you. If you don't have my spirit in you, you will never be able to serve me. Peter, you keep on hiding like a chicken. Thomas, you keep on doubting. You cannot serve me. You cannot carry. You will waste the cross. You need the Holy Ghost. And so he told them, go and tarry, go and wait. So I'm going to the book of Acts chapter 1, verse number 8. Acts chapter 1, verse number 8. Sakuli Brakasandra. There was a prophecy that manifested.
Acts chapter 1, verse 8.
Read it first.
But ye shall receive power.
The Bible says, but ye shall receive power.
After that, the Holy Ghost is come upon you.
After that, you do not get power before the Holy Ghost. You shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you.
And
you
shall be witnesses.
Why? Because the Holy Ghost is for witness. The Holy Ghost is to preach. The Holy Ghost is to glorify God. The Holy Ghost is not for you to use and prove that you are a Christian and be making noise all over the place. The Holy Ghost is purely for divine assignments. There is a purpose for the Holy Ghost. It's to be a witness.
Yes. And you shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem.
In Jerusalem from your house. You will start from inside the house. Yes. And be witnessing. Yes. If you have the Holy Ghost and your family does not feel the Holy Ghost that you have, you don't have the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost starts manifesting right from your house before it begins to spread to every part of the world. Beloved, there is a scripture that was prophesied. There was a prophecy about the Holy Ghost in the book of Joel chapter 2, verse number 28 to 30. Joel chapter 2, 28 to 30.
Joel chapter 2.
Yes, sir.
28 to 30.
Yes.
And it shall come to pass afterward.
The Bible says it shall come to pass afterward.
That I will pour out my spirit upon all.
God is the one talking. He said, afterward, I'm going to pour my spirit upon all flesh.
And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy.
And your sons, me and you, we shall prophesy.
Your old men shall dream dreams.
Old men shall, will not be left out. They will dream dreams. Their gifts will come.
Your young men shall see visions.
Young men will see visions.
And also upon the servants and upon the handmaids.
The servants, the handmaids, everybody. In those days,
will I pour out my
God
spirit?
God says, I am the one that will pour my spirit. When I am ready, I will pour my spirit. Yes.
And I will show wonders.
God said, I'll begin to show wonders.
And in the earth.
Yes.
Blood and fire. And pillars of smoke.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
As this prophecy was given, it manifested. Yes. In the book of Acts chapter 2, we saw the manifestation. Yes. The manifestation of this prophecy came in the book of Acts chapter 2 from verse 1.
Acts chapter 2 verse 1.
Yes, sir.
And when the day of Pentecost was fully come. Yes,
and when the day of Pentecost was fully come.
They were all with one accord in one place.
They were all with one accord in one place. Now listen to me. This Pentecost has always been there from the beginning.
Yes, sir.
The Holy Ghost did not come as by Pentecost. That is when the Holy Ghost came to establish Pentecost. Pentecost was already there. It was a time of feasting.
Yes.
It was a time of eating and drinking. It's not as though, it's not as if now you want to travel you want to travel, and they say you traveled the same time that the wife of your president gave birth. You're not going to say your travel is based on her giving birth. It's just that that is the period to use, because everybody will recognize it. Because it's a popular person, it's a president. The period that his wife gave birth is when you traveled. So the Pentecost was already an existing feast that the Israelites that they observed according to God's ordinance. It was in that time the Lord came and changed their program from eating and drinking to makuli bakata. The Lord came and manifested himself. Read on, my son.
And suddenly there came a sound from
heaven. The Bible said they were in one accord.
In one
they were in one place. They were waiting upon the Lord. They were together. Nobody had their own agenda. Everybody was in one place, one accord, one holiness, one spirit. They were not struggling with fornicators. They were not struggling with people with second wife. Everybody was on one page of holiness because they had been tarrying. They had been waiting. And that waiting period was a period of preparation, a period of repentance, a period of putting their lives in order. So be in one accord, because Holy Ghost does not move in a scattered place. You cannot see Holy Ghost where there is fighting, where there is strife, where there is immorality. You cannot see Holy Ghost in a place where they are playing politics. Read on,
suddenly,
the Bible says, suddenly.
There came a sound from heaven.
They threw their jacket.
A sound from heaven.
They blew.
There came a sound from heaven.
The Bible says suddenly a sound came from where they cannot control. A sound came from
heaven.
Yes.
As of a rushing.
As of a rushing mighty wind.
And it filled all the house.
And it filled all the
house. Where they were sitting.
We are there, we are standing.
Where they were sitting.
You can be sitting and the Holy Ghost will come. You can be sitting in the Holy Ghost with God. It doesn't mean you must kneel down. It doesn't mean you must be shouting up and down. You can be seated. The most important thing is the state of your heart. How ready are you for God? It's not by jumping up and down or making noise. How ready are you for God? Because God is expensive.
Yes.
The Holy Ghost is not cheap. It's a baptism of fire. You can easily just get salvation, but to get the Holy Ghost, to get the fire, you have to desire him. You have to want him. You have to show him that he is important to you. The Bible says, where they are sitting, read on.
And there appeared
unto them. Cloven tongues like as of fire.
And it sat upon each of them.
And it sat on the pastors.
And it sat upon each of them.
He sat on the choristers.
He sat upon each of them.
Who did the Holy Ghost sit on?
Each of them.
The Bible said the Holy Ghost sat on every one of them. From the beginning to the end. All the teenagers, all the youths, all the elders, all the housemates, all the nannies, even the drivers, the security guard. The Holy Ghost came and sat upon every one of them. Why are we not seeing it in our churches today? Why the Holy Ghost not sitting on everybody? Because we are not ready for him. Because we're not ready for the Holy Ghost. Because we are not in one accord. Because we are mingling and we are mixing. And we are joking with his presence. And the Bible says that we are all filled with the Holy Ghost. And began to speak. You want to speak?
Speak.
They began to speak with
other tongues.
With other tongues.
As the Spirit gave them utterance.
As they taught them in Holy Ghost school.
As the Spirit gave them
utterance. There are some churches that teach people how to speak in tongues. They gather them and say, let's teach you how to speak in tongues. They call it Holy Ghost school. They teach people how to speak in tongues. They tell you, toko, follow me. Toko. That is not the Holy Ghost. That is Bible College Ghost. That is church ghost. That is not a genuine Holy Ghost. The one that came upon the disciples and the women. Because there were women there. They were catches there. There were kerchiefs there. There were danners there. Who is the woman there? They were all there, waiting for the Holy Ghost. They were all filled and began to speak with other tongues. As the Spirit, look at the S, it's a capital S. As the Spirit, the Holy Spirit gave them utterance. He did not copy the tongues of their pastor. He did not say that one is a senior tongue. They didn't copy the tongue of gospel singer. But they see gospel singer, they repeat each other's tongues. They speak the same thing. You can speak in tongues, but it cannot be the Holy Ghost tongue if you are copying each other. Speaking in tongues does not mean you have the Holy Ghost. Demons speak in tongues. Anybody can speak in tongues. If you are a Chinese, you can speak Chinese language, and you find yourself in maybe one African country, maybe in Zambia, when you speak China, they will think it's tongues. They don't know that it is China language. This utterance is not utterance of copy. Yesterday I saw a chorister singing a song of a gospel singer, and he was speaking the exact tongues the gospel singer was singing. That is idolatry. You are worshipping the gospel singer. When you find yourself trying to imitate, the Bible calls it that it is a work of the flesh. In Galatians chapter 5, verse 20. Galatians 5, 20, the Bible says, when you begin to copy, when you begin to emulate, the Bible says you are walking in the flesh, and the flesh profited nothing. So you have to go back to the book of Acts chapter 1. I want to prove to myself and everyone that Ikechi was there.
And when they were coming,
the Bible says, when the disciples were coming,
they went up into an upper room.
They went up into an upper room. Yeah. You don't need any special room. This is where they gather. Because they are more than 100. This is where they gather. Your upper room can be in your bathroom. Your upper room can be in your kitchen. Your upper room can be in your bedroom. Your upper room can be in your garden. Your upper room can be anywhere. Anywhere you are desiring God. When the Lord comes to you, there is no protocol.
Here are both Peter and James.
They began to call the names of the men. Peter, James,
and
John,
John and Andrew,
Andrew, Philip,
and Thomas,
Thomas,
Bartholomew,
and Matthew, yes.
James, the son of Alphaeus,
James, the son of Alphaeus,
and Simon
Zealous, yes.
And Judas, the brother
and Judas,
of James.
The brother of James, not Iscariot is dead. Verse 14.
These all continued with one accord.
The Bible said they were praying. They were in the upper room praying with one accord, yes.
With prayer and supplication.
They were not praying for miracle of food, of business, of contract. They were not looking for children. They were not there to pray for anything material. They are praying for their Holy Ghost. They are crying to God. Father, whatever is in my life, anyone I have not forgiven, every loss in me, every doubt in me, oh, put it, Lord. They are repenting. They are consecrating themselves to God. They are rejecting their evil character. And Allah Shikayanda, yes?
With the women.
With Ikechi. With Ikechi was there.
That's right.
With the women.
And Mary, the mother of Jesus.
And Mary, the mother of Jesus.
And with his brethren.
And with his brothers and his sisters. When I saw this scripture, I began to thank God that Jesus was a responsible son. He handed over his mother of the flesh to John at the cross. And to prove to you that John was a responsible disciple, John carried his mother to the upper room to receive the Holy Ghost. Every mother watching me, I don't care how old you are eligible for the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is for everybody. The revival started 2,000 years ago in the book of Acts chapter 2. The revival that we are pursuing today, that to welcome our Lord Jesus, that revival started 2,000 years ago, and that revival is here, and it's getting hotter and hotter, and I am going to enjoy the Holy Ghost in this end time, in the mighty name of Jesus. The Holy Ghost came for an assignment, and boldness came upon the disciples. The chicken Peter that was a chicken became bold and began to preach the gospel. When you receive the Holy Ghost, you will not be ashamed to preach. When you receive the Holy Ghost, you will not struggle with what to say. When you receive the Holy Ghost, you will know what to say. Listen to me. Holy Ghost is not handkerchief.
No, sir.
Holy Ghost is not oil.
No, sir.
He can manifest through oil. If Holy Ghost is not in your olive oil, it is an ordinary oil to go and fry plantain. The Holy Ghost must be in that oil. And it is not a talisman. There is a reason for that oil. When the Holy Ghost enters oil, it's because he wants to heal the sick somewhere. It's not for us to use it as voodoo. It's not for voodoo. God is calling us today. The Holy Ghost is not a shivering spirit. It's not a fever. Holy Ghost. You can be shivering like a cannibal fornication. The Holy Ghost is holy. The purpose of the Holy Ghost is to make me and you holy. Is to teach us holy things. Make us to love holy things. The Holy Ghost is to make me and you to hate sin. To hate evil. To hate worldliness. The Holy Ghost is not for form. It's not for noise. There is a purpose for the Holy Ghost. If you are having the Holy Ghost as you claim, and you find yourself that you are still lying, your character has not changed. You don't have the Holy Ghost. Because the Holy Ghost is to make us to hate sin. Peter became bold after he received the Holy Ghost. And he preached a powerful sermon. No more fear. He confronted the Jews. He confronted the Pharisees. He confronted everyone and told them how they killed Jesus. And look at what happened to them after the preaching. When you preach by the power of the Holy Ghost, there is instant result. Verse 37. What does he say?
Verse 37.
Yes, sir.
Now, when they heard this,
when he finished, because of time, we cannot read the sermon up to verse 36. You begin to see the preaching, the message that Apostle Peter preached because he has received power to be a witness. You will receive power today. Say, I will receive power in the mighty name of Jesus. Christians are not going to rush the Holy Ghost. We are going to follow him sequence by sequence. If you want to take us for 2 weeks, we will follow him. Because at the end of this ride with the Holy Ghost, our lives will be transformed. We will not be chickens anymore. We will not be struggling with the flesh anymore. The Holy Ghost will saturate and permeate everything in our lives and give us the power to live above sin in the mighty name of Jesus. What happened in verse 37?
And when they heard this, they were preaching their
hearts. When the people heard the message,
they were preaching their hearts.
Many pastors are not preaching with the Holy Ghost. That is why when they finish preaching, people are laughing. There is no conviction. Nobody is touched. Because you cannot represent God without the Holy Ghost. If you must represent God, his spirit must be in you. Many puppets do not have God. Because the person standing there does not have the spirit of God in him. That is why the message is empty. No conviction. That's why I can go there and apologize. That's why you go there to watch what he will say. Any preacher that is watching what he will say is not operating with the Holy Ghost. You are editing the word of God. Rakana, the Lord is not in your mouth. Apostle Peter did not edit the message. It came out raw. He had no sermon notes. It came out raw. And he began to convict the people. Yes? They began to request. When people are under the atmosphere of the Holy Ghost, they beg for God. They cry. They want God. They don't want the preacher. They want God. What do we do? What do we do? What shall we do? They are the ones that want to be saved. Macaulay Mokosuna. Yes, sir.
Then Peter said unto them.
Then Bishop Peter.
Peter said unto them.
G.O. Peter.
Peter.
The Bible says then Peter.
Said unto them.
No title. You don't need to have title after you receive Holy Ghost. The Bible said, then Peter said unto the people,
repent.
Repent. The first word that should come out of the mouth of a Holy Ghost filled preacher is repent.
And be baptized.
And be baptized.
Every one of you.
Every one of you be baptized.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Be born of water. Be born of water. In the name of Jesus Christ.
for the remission of sins.
So your sins will be remitted.
And you shall receive the gift of the
then
Holy Ghost.
You can receive the Holy Ghost. It's a gift. It's a gift for everybody. Go to the 39. Go to 39.
39.
Yes.
For the promise is unto you.
The promise and the promise of God
is unto you.
Is unto you.
Unto your children.
Your children.
And to all that are far off.
Far to the village. God said they are. The Holy Ghost is for them.
That's right.
The Holy Ghost is not restricted to people in America.
That's right.
The Holy Ghost is for people in the UK. It's not for any special people. The Holy Ghost is for everybody to the hinterlands, to the hamlets, to the deep villages. God said, I am going there with the Holy Ghost. Because my word must come to pass the book of Joel chapter 2. Child of God, which ghost is in you? When the Holy Ghost is inside of you, you have no fear of man. When the Holy Ghost is inside of you, you are never satisfied with yourself. You just want to keep on driving in God. You are hungry for God. You are ready to speak for God and defend God. God said the Holy Ghost had been quenched. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse number 19. The Holy Ghost can be quenched. The Holy Ghost can be quenched. Read it. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse number 19. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse number 19.
Quench not the spirit.
The Bible says, quench not the spirit. The Holy Spirit. Don't quench the Holy Spirit. Read on. Is it finished?
Yes.
Look at the S. It's a big S.
Yes.
Don't quench. You can quench the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
When you lie, you quench him.
Yes.
When you watch Big Brother Nigeria, you have quenched him.
Uh-huh.
He goes. You've quenched him. When you begin to watch this romantic thing, any child of God, you say you have the Holy Ghost in you, and you're watching Big Brother Nigeria, Big Brother Africa, you do not have the Holy Ghost.
Yes, sir.
You have film ghosts.
Yes.
You have movie ghosts.
Yes.
You have immorality ghosts.
Yes.
You have lost ghosts. I read it in the news, in the media, that an evangelist is one of the housemates in Big Brother Nigeria. An evangelist. That evangelist is not the evangelist of this Bible. If you have the Holy Ghost in you, you will know that Big Brother Nigeria is sponsored by Lucifer.
Yes.
Once you begin to watch sexual movies, once you begin to do the things that the Spirit of God, he can be quenched. You can quench God in your life. You can quench him. You can grieve him. You can annoy him. Ephesians chapter 4 verse 30. You can annoy God. You can make him angry. You can make him grieved. You can give God sorrow with your lying, with your immorality, with your fighting, with your divorce. You can grieve God's heart. Ephesians chapter 4 verse number 30.
And grieve not the Holy Spirit of God.
The Bible says, and grieve not the Holy Spirit of God.
We are by here as seed unto the day of
that death. Is the Spirit of God that will carry you to make heaven at last. When you continue living in sin, the Bible said you grieve him, and he will be grieved, and he will not be able to defend you on that day. Your salvation will be crushed. Your salvation will be crumbled. The Holy Ghost has a role in our lives. John chapter 14 verse 26. John 15, 26. John 16, 7, 13, 14. John 14, 26. John 15, 26. John 16, 7, 13, and 14. Let's run with those scriptures.
John chapter 14, verse 26.
Yes, sir.
For the Comforter.
But the Comforter.
Which the Holy Ghost.
Which the Holy Ghost.
Which is the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Whom the Father will send in my name.
Whom the Father will send in the name of Jesus.
He shall teach you all things.
The Holy Ghost is a teacher. The Holy Ghost is a teacher. If you have the Holy Ghost here, he will teach you how to pray. He will teach you how to read the Bible. When you are reading the Bible, he'll be explaining the things to you. When the Holy Ghost is in you, you'll be comforted. When they insult you, the Holy Ghost knows how to calm your wound. The Holy Ghost comfortable when they are going through trouble. You don't leave church because you are sick, nobody visited you. You don't have the Holy Ghost. When you have the Holy Ghost and you are sick, nobody visits you, the Holy Ghost is your comforter.
Yes,
he is there to comfort you. Yes, nobody can push you out of God. Yes, because you have the Holy Ghost. You have the Spirit of God inside of you. Yes, sir, read on.
He shall teach you all things.
He shall teach you some things.
All things.
He will teach you how to have sex, sister.
Yes.
He will teach you the kind of pants to wear.
Yes.
He will teach you the kind of bra to wear.
Yes.
Oh, somebody say, oh.
Oh.
The Holy Ghost teaches all things.
And bring all things to your remembrance.
He will remind you of things. All you students that are going to school, the Holy Ghost can remind you what you read. When you read and you are going for exam, you are going for interview, the Holy Ghost can remind you in exam hall. He can open your book invisible. He can open your book in exam hall. People will not see it, but you are seeing your book. I am a witness. Somebody over there say, I shall enjoy the Holy Ghost. In the mighty name of Jesus. It's a gift to me. It's a gift to you. The Bible says he is a reminder. You will know how to memorize scripture. When you read Bible, he will remind you of the scripture. Because I don't know how to memorize. We don't cram Bible. We have a Holy Spirit that reminds us. It has happened many times at this global altar. Many times I forget scripture and the Holy Ghost come and whisper to me. He will say, this is scripture. Oh, the Holy Ghost is here. He's a reminder. He's the one that makes your brain to be active. Read on to the next verse.
Whatever I have said unto you.
Whatever I have said. Whatever the Lord has said to you, the Holy Ghost is there to remind you. And you will not forget the name of Jesus. 15:26.
But when the Comforter is come.
Again, look at it. 26:26. Not a coincidence. Double. When God begins to talk two times, it's not an ordinary talk. Holy Ghost is here. He said, yes.
But when the Comforter is come.
Again, in case you didn't read 14:26, look at it in 15:26. He said, but when the Comforter is come.
Whom I will send unto you from the Father.
I will send from the Father.
Even the Spirit of truth.
Somebody say, Spirit of truth. When you have the Holy Ghost in you, you cannot lie. When you have the Holy Ghost in you, we hate lies. You will love truth. You cannot tell me you have the Holy Ghost in you and you love lies. You don't want the truth. When you are preaching holiness, you get angry. What is truth? Truth is holiness. Truth is everything God has said. If you have the Spirit of truth, the Holy Ghost in you, you will never fight teaching of God. You will not fight truth preachers. You will love them because the same Spirit is at work in both of you. Holy Ghost is God, the Spirit of truth. Yes.
Which proceeded from the Father.
He came from the Father.
He shall testify of me.
Holy Ghost does not testify of pastors. He testifies of God.
Yes, sir.
When you see a pastor who wants to be recognized all the time, the Holy Ghost is not in him. He wants to give glory to God.
Yes.
It's not about me. It's about God. There are signs to know people that have the Holy Ghost. One of the signs to know people that have the Holy Ghost, they do not speak about themselves. They talk about God. They give glory to God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Read the truth is in John chapter 16 verse 7. Read it.
John chapter 16 and read verse 7.
Yes, sir.
Nevertheless, I tell you the truth.
Nevertheless, I tell you the truth.
It is expedient for me, for you, that I go away.
God said, Jesus said, I will go. Yes.
For if I go not away,
if I don't go,
the Comforter will not come unto you.
God, the Spirit of God will not come because I cannot walk with you in the flesh all the time. The flesh is limited.
That's right.
And
but if I depart,
my assignment is over. Okay. Yes.
But if I depart, I will send him unto you.
I will send the Holy Ghost to you.
That's
yes.
Right.
Yes.
How be it when he
the Spirit of truth
is come.
Is come.
He will guide you into all truth.
He will guide you to prosper. He will guide you to travel all over the place. The Bible said the Holy Ghost has a duty. His duty is to guide you and I.
Into all truth.
Somebody say all. Into the truth of family planning.
Yes.
That's right.
Thank you.
Into the truth of IVF.
Thank you, Jesus.
So Holy Ghost can explain to you secret things.
Yes.
Because he knows all things.
Thank
the Spirit is such a deep things of God.
Yes.
If you have the Holy Ghost in you, he will give you the truth about everything. He will reveal secrets to you. God told me we do not believe him. We do not walk with him. That is why we are suffering. We are walking in the flesh. We are not receiving the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is not the Holy Spirit, because Spirit and Ghost, they are interused. Is that you say Holy Ghost or Holy Spirit, they are the same. The Holy Ghost will guide you. He will tell you, this is the way to go. Go like this. Don't marry that man. That man is a liar. That man is a fake man. Don't marry him. He may look nice. God said, I don't look for nice children. God said, I didn't call you to be nice. I called you to be holy. He said, no child of mine should be nice. Christians should not be nice. Christians should be holy. Who is a nice man? A nice man, a nice woman is that man or woman that is loved by everybody. And no child of God is permitted to be loved by everybody. I call you to be holy, not to be nice. When you are nice, you will bow, you will compromise, you will follow the word. Because nice is a worldly terminology. Nice is a fleshy terminology. From Genesis to Revelation, you've not seen the word nice. He didn't call us for niceness. He called us for holiness. He called us for truth. He called us for mercy. He called us to be kind. He called us to have a good heart. The Bible says, For he
shall not speak of himself.
He will not speak of himself. That is how you know a true preacher.
Yes.
Yes.
But whatsoever he shall
hear. He is 40 years as a puppet.
That shall he speak.
That is what he will speak.
And he will show you things to come.
He will show you the future. Look, beloved, because of lack of Holy Ghost, did we see coronavirus?
No.
Did we see COVID-19?
No.
Because we refused to consult the Holy Ghost. So there was no revelation. This God cannot lie. He said, I will show you things to come. I will reveal the future to you. Because we couldn't wait on the Holy Ghost. We were in a hurry for our own things. The Holy Ghost could not reveal to us and say, my children, look at the secret. Look at what they are planning. Look at what they want to do. And make us to be ready. We are pursuing how to have big auditoriums. We are pursuing how to have money. We are pursuing other things. We forgot God and God Almighty allowed the devil to have his way. For God is going to restore his people. The Holy Ghost is coming back. We will begin to wait on God. We will pray the mind of God. We will obey God. What God says, what we hear, is what we are going to obey. In the mighty name of Jesus. Child of God, which ghost is in you? Is it your pastor ghost? Is it your bishop ghost? Because some Christians, they cannot defend God. But once you mention their pastor, they fear you. They eat you raw. You don't have the Holy Ghost. If you have the Holy Ghost will reveal the truth about your pastor. If you have the Holy Ghost will tell you that your pastor has backslided. He will show you the secret of your pastor. He will not worship man. He will give righteous judgment. The Holy Ghost is here to give on this global altar. Is anyone testing? John chapter 7. Is anyone testing?
Yes,
is anyone testing?
Yes,
John chapter 7, Macaulay 38 and 39. John 7, 38 and 39.
John chapter
8. John chapter 7.
38 and 39.
Yes,
have believed on me.
The Bible says, what you need is to believe God.
As the scripture has said.
As the Bible said.
Out of his belly shall flow.
Out of his belly shall flow. River. Out of living water. As a child. Child of God, that's what a struggle. It's still flow. If you have the Holy Ghost, you can speak in tongues for 3 hours, you will not know.
Yes.
It's a flow, it's living water. Yes. You will not be praying the God. He says, I want to be in the mood. You want the Holy Ghost. He said, put music, put this particular music. Whenever I hear this music, I feel the Holy Ghost. If you need music to feel the Holy Ghost, you don't have the Holy Ghost, you have good faithful ghosts. If you have the Holy Ghost, call the Boko Shondaya. You can wake up in the morning and learn Boko Shondaya. Because the Holy Ghost manifests with speaking with tongues that we do not understand. And I will tell you why. I give verse 39.
But this speaking of the Spirit.
Speaking of the Spirit of God.
Which they that believe.
They that believe to receive.
Yes, for the Holy Ghost was not yet given.
Because the Holy Ghost was not yet given, because Jesus was not yet. The Holy Ghost came for an assignment.
Yes.
It's not for fun. It's not a handbag to be carrying about. It's not a sticker on the face that you say, I have the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost will have to come for us to continue the assignment that be given to us. 1 Corinthians chapter 14. Why do we need the Holy Ghost? 1 Corinthians chapter 14. Makuni ganda la kale poko sundaya. Hey, kaka kaka. Hey, oh, la kaya ganda la baba ya. Now, read on.
1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 2.
Yes, sir.
For he that speaketh in an unknown tongue.
The Bible says when you speak in an unknown tongue.
Speaketh unto men.
This tongue we're talking about is not by your making.
For he that
speaketh. I have been speaking in tongues by the grace of God for 35 years. August 1985, I received the Holy Ghost. I received the Holy Ghost. My life changed. I received the Holy Ghost August 1985. I cannot forget. And from that day till today, I am growing. The Holy Ghost is flowing in me. I don't think of what to say. As I open my mouth, the Holy Ghost is giving me utterance. I don't have understanding. Read all he said.
For
he
that speaketh in an unknown tongue. Speaketh not unto men.
I'm not speaking for human beings.
But unto God.
So you can abuse me. You can insult me. What is she saying? You make fun of me. You go to a canal. Canal people laugh at people who speak in tongues. They see it as funny. It makes them to have comedy. But the Bible says we are not speaking to men. We are speaking unto God.
For yes. No man understandeth him.
The Bible says nobody will understand me.
How be it in the spirit he speaketh?
In the spirit realm. Things are happening. I am speaking mysteries. The sick is getting healed. My brother that is traveling, as I'm speaking in tongues, God is packaging the tongues. To give him turning mercy. God is using the tongues in the realm of the spirit to walk in China in case somebody there needs the word, needs prayer. God uses it, his mysteries. It produces energy. When you speak in tongues, you are producing spiritual energy. You are banking power. You are banking energy of the spirit. It's not like when you are having sex, when you are committing fornication, when you are committing adultery, you are gathering energy for the devil to use and operate. The same thing that happened to married men and women. A married man and a married woman, when they are having their legal matrimonial sex, they are gathering energy to preserve their home. Speaking in tongues is mysteries. So I'm quoting this verse 4. Verse 4.
He does speak in an unknown tongue.
Yes.
And defieth himself.
When you speak in an unknown tongue, Bible says you are building yourself.
But he that prophesieth.
But he that prophesieth.
And defieth the church.
Prophecy is for the church. And it comes with the Holy Spirit. When you speak in tongues, you are building up yourself. Go to verse 15. You are building up yourself. Verse 15, verse 18, verse 22. 15, 18, 22. Please take out time to read 1 Corinthians chapter 14.
What is it then?
What is it then?
I will pray with the spirit.
Apostle Paul said, me, I will pray in the spirit.
And I will pray with the understanding.
And I will
also.
Pray with understanding.
I will sing with the spirit.
I will sing with the spirit.
And I will sing with the understanding.
I
also.
Will sing with understanding also. Yes. Apostle Paul said, I can do the two.
Yes, sir.
I can pray with understanding. I can pray with the spirit. But beloved, listen to me. If you don't have the Holy Ghost, praying with understanding will limit you.
Yes.
You will soon get tired of praying.
Yes.
But when you pray with the Holy Ghost, there is a garnishing.
Yes.
There is a strength coming. There is a flow, a lubrication. There is a lubrication in your prayer. Speaking in tongues, the power of the Holy Ghost is speaking in tongues. It makes you to be strong in the face of prayer. You can pray for hours, you will not know. You'll be generating energy. You'll be sweating like as I am here. I have a conditioner here. I have 2 fans, but I'm still sweating. That is the Holy Ghost. The Bible says Jesus prayed in the spirit until his sweat became drops of blood. That is, when you operate in the Holy Ghost and you become a supernatural being. What does verse 18 say?
I thank my God.
Apostle Paul said, I thank my God.
I speak with tongues more than you.
I speak with tongues more than you. Oh. Can you come to a contest? Who can enter a contest with me? Let us speak in tongues. After 1 hour, let us see who is going to keep quiet. Speak in tongues for 1 minute. Everybody, speak in tongues. Holy Ghost, in Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. Beloved. power. Read the last verse,
22. Wherefore tongues are for a sign.
Tongues are for a sign.
Not to them that believe.
Not for the believers.
But to them that believe not.
Unbelievers need to know that we have a supernatural language. We have a dynamis. We have fire. You have been baptized by fire. Yes.
But prophesy is serveth not for them that believe not.
Yes.
But for them which believe.
When you give prophecy to unbelievers, they don't understand what you're saying. They'll be laughing and making mockery. Prophecy is a joke to them. But when we speak in tongues, they will be looking around. They may wonder, why am I different? Why am I not speaking in tongues? It is a sign to them that really they're in the midst of fire carriers. Matthew 3:17. What does it say? Matthew 3:17. Makoni Bakaya, the Holy Ghost, I give you praise. Matthew chapter 3, verse number 17.
And no, a voice from heaven.
So go to 11 first. Go to 11. Makaya and the Lagoko Sundaya. Matthew 3.
I indeed baptize you with water unto
the Apostle John was telling them, yes.
I indeed baptize you with water.
I baptize you with water.
Unto repentance.
Unto repentance.
For he that cometh after me.
For he that is coming after me.
Is mightier than I.
That is Jesus.
Amen.
He prepared the way for Jesus. Amen. He says, mightier than me, yes.
Whose shoes I am not worthy to bear.
I'm not worthy to open his shoes. Yes.
He shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost.
He, not your pastor. Amen. Many people are operating under pastoral Holy Ghost. Pastoral Ghost, not holy. There's only one Holy Ghost.
Yes.
That is God. They're operating under church ghosts. They learned it. God is saying that He, Jesus, is the one that will baptize me and you. With what?
With the Holy Ghost.
With the Holy Ghost and with fire. With the fire. Holy Ghost with fire is not for demons. Holy Ghost with fire is for children of God.
Yes.
So when you are going to fight battle, you say, Holy Ghost, fire. You are wasting it. Nothing will happen. Because Holy Ghost fire is not for demons. Holy Ghost fire is for me and you. We are in error. They are going astray. They are calling Holy Ghost fire for demon. And the demon is still fighting. The demon is still beating everybody down. Hey, may God open the eyes of his people. In the mighty name of Jesus. Next time you want to shout Holy Ghost fire, remember today's message. You are wasting it. You shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost and with fire. You are to bind demons. When you see demons, you bind them and you cast them out. Reserve your energy of the Spirit to serve God, to preach the gospel, to lay hands on the sick that they will recover, to live the holy life. Is it finished?
Verse 17. No, a voice from heaven saying,
yes,
this is my beloved son.
Jesus was recognized.
In whom I am well.
God recognized the one that he has chosen from the house of Mary. John, when you look up Jude chapter 1, verse number 20. Jude chapter 1, verse number 20. Record to me. The Holy Ghost is not when you run around the church shouting, Kai, 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 Kai. That is not the Holy Ghost. Hey, Nakoriana.
But ye beloved.
Holy Ghost. Look at it in Jude chapter 1.
But ye beloved.
But ye beloved.
Building up yourselves.
The Bible says you have to build yourself. I am to build myself.
On your most holy face.
Somebody say most holy.
Most holy.
The Bible says, but ye beloved. Building up yourself, myself.
On your most holy face. Praying in the Holy
Ghost. Praying in the Lusa. Praying in the Holy Ghost. Anytime you pray in the Holy Ghost, you are building your most holy faith. You are connecting with the faith of God. You are connecting with the power of God. Whenever you pray in the Holy Ghost, the flesh begins to die. When you pray in the Holy Ghost, your faith in God becomes established. Building up yourself it is my duty, it is your duty. Stop copying the tongues of your bishop, of your general overseer. It will not build you. Building up yourself
on your own holy faith.
No, on the bishop's head,
on your own holy faith.
On the general overseer's thoughts.
On
your own most holy faith. Doing what?
Praying in the Holy Ghost.
No, playing the acidity of Holy Ghost.
Praying.
You know, some pastors pray in tongues and put in phone. As ringtone. As some fools look and listen to it and say they are receiving the anointing. God deliver this generation in the mighty name of Jesus. Build up yourself, child of God.
On your most holy.
We are in a time for everyone to have their own energy.
Yes.
You cannot depend on the energy of any pastor.
Yes.
Because the pastor also is looking for energy.
Yes.
So you know some pastors only have strength when they see you. God is saying it's time for you to arise and receive your own gifts. There's no special Holy Ghost for pastors. It is one Holy Ghost. The same Holy Ghost Peter received, Mary received it. The same. There is no speciality. We only grow in grace. If your Holy Ghost is to be running up and down the church, child of God, go and sit down. Maybe you feel like easing yourself. God Almighty is calling you on to the real Holy Ghost. Original Holy Ghost. The one I received that gave me boldness. That when my parents told me to get out, I was able to leave the house. I didn't think about that I'm a teenager. I left the house because I have received power. Who can comfort me? The Holy Ghost comforted me. The Holy Ghost told me, my daughter, don't worry. Suffer a little while. They will come back someday. Just endure. Your endurance is their salvation. If they can see you enduring, they will believe in me. Child of God, which ghost is in you? Do you still have the same Holy Ghost that you had that time? That you wake up in the morning and you go for morning ground, you go and preach. This that Holy Ghost that you had that time. That when you lie, you cry. You don't eat for 2 days. You cry forever saying a lie. Do you still have that same Holy Ghost? That you cannot wake up in the morning and walk out without having what they call quiet time, spending time with God. Do you still have that same Holy Ghost? That you are conscious of your dressing. You cannot dress anyhow. You wanted to please God with your body. Do you still have that same Holy Ghost? Now when you have done something wrong, you are not comfortable to go and join the choir. You go to the corner and be crying. You are not bold to grab the pulpit. Because you had the fear of God. That if you grab the pulpit, you are going to offer straight fire. And God can strike you. Really the fear of God. The Holy Ghost makes us to fear God. The Holy Ghost makes us to fear God. The Holy Ghost is not in prosperity. It is in righteousness, peace and joy. Romans chapter 14, verse number 17. Romans chapter 14, verse number 17. Romans chapter 14, verse 17. Hey, Holy Ghost. I just feel like pushing away my chair. I feel like running. I feel like shouting. Hey, the Holy Ghost.
For the kingdom of God is not in meat and
drink. The Bible said the kingdom of God
is not in meat.
It's not in driving cheap. It's not in being great in this world. It's not in having big auditoriums. Because some people are worshiping their auditoriums.
But righteousness and peace.
The kingdom of God is righteousness
and peace.
And peace.
And joy in the Holy Ghost.
And joy. We are
in the Holy Ghost.
In the church position.
In the Holy Ghost.
In the marriage.
In the Holy Ghost.
If your joy is because of the things that you have, you don't have the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is not based on anything you have. The Holy Ghost is based on the righteousness of God. Righteousness, peace,
joy in the Holy Ghost.
Yes, sir.
Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. That's the kingdom of God.
One more time.
Righteousness, peace, joy in the Holy Ghost.
Hey, God, I am.
Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. Hey. That's the kingdom of God. Don't you want to be a part of the kingdom? Don't you want to be a part of the kingdom? Don't you want to be a part of the kingdom?
Come on.
Come on, everybody. Don't you want to be a part of the kingdom? Don't you want to be a part of the kingdom?
Oh,
don't you want to be a part of the kingdom? Come on, everybody.
The Holy Ghost is for everybody. Our righteousness, joy, peace, that is what makes you to be a carrier of the Holy Ghost. It doesn't matter your financial status. You can be poor, you don't have money, and you have the Holy Ghost, you have joy, you are qualified for the kingdom of God. And you will enter in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Nothing will stop you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will not be intimidated in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hey, Calabo Kosunda. And my greatest treasure is the Holy Ghost. Because with the Holy Ghost, I can enter the house of the president.
Yes.
I heal them of their cancer. My greatest treasure is the Holy Ghost. What money cannot buy? Hey, nobody can buy the Holy Ghost. God give it as He pleases. We will be filled with the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Ephesians chapter 5, 18 and 19. Ephesians 5, 18 and 19. Hey, my God, sweetheart child of God, the Holy Ghost is here. And He will carry us if Jesus carries on Friday. If He doesn't finish with us on Friday, He will carry us next week. If Jesus carries, even if He's going to stay for 1 month. I don't know if you'll be judging on the river of so Ephesians chapter 5, 18 and 19.
And be not drunk with wine.
The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 5, don't be drunk with wine.
Herein is excess.
Don't be drunk with sex. Don't be drunk with fashion. Don't be drunk with movies. Don't be drunk with money. Don't be drunk with position. Don't be drunk with beauty. Don't be drunk with this.
Learning is excess.
God said this thing is filled with excess flesh.
But be filled with the
Spirit. But, say, but be filled
with the Spirit.
Be filled with the Spirit of God. Read all.
Speaking to yourselves in song.
When you are filled with the Holy Ghost, hey, listen to me, couple singer, you will not sing all these your foolish songs. When you are filled with the Holy Ghost and you open your mouth to sing, souls will be saved. People will cry for their sin. Your songs will not be about Donna. Your song will not be about how God is making you sugar, sugar. God doesn't make us sugar, sugar. God cannot make you sugar, sugar when He sees that you know how to lie. When He sees your dressing, the Spirit of truth cannot be in you, sister, and you still want to wear trousers. The Spirit of God cannot be in you. The Spirit of truth cannot be in you. I'll be giving you money. If the Spirit of truth is in you, the first thing He will point is your character. He will point what you are wearing. He will point at your boyfriend. He will point at your girlfriend. He will break your television. I remember when I went to preach, son, I'm coming, and I carried iPad. I wanted to be like my fellow preachers. I went with iPad. I put the iPad on the pulpit. You lost the instruction to wear your iPad. I don't want your iPad here. I said, Lord, I want to be like others. If you told me that when they carry this big book, I want to carry my iPad. So I carried the iPad. I put it on the pulpit. As I was watching when the Holy Ghost is in you, He will not allow you to mess up. As I was about to preach, the Holy Ghost came and and wiped out everything from the iPad. He said, in Kachi, have I not told you? I don't want to see this. I burn on my pulpit. I suffered that day. I couldn't preach. I was begging God. I said, you know, sometimes when preachers are singing plenty of songs, don't think that they want to worship God. They are confused. You don't know what to say. I was singing, and people thought that I wanted to sing. I don't know that I don't know what to sing. Holy Ghost, remove the preaching from the iPad. When the Holy Ghost is in you, He will not allow you to do as you like. Don't rejoice because you are getting away with your flesh. You don't have the spirit of truth. Don't cry for Him. Let Him come and correct your life. Son, is that scripture finished?
Speaking to yourselves in Psalms.
The Bible says when you have the spirit of God in you, you will not sing nonsense songs. You begin to sing psalms.
And hymns.
You begin to sing holy songs.
And spiritual songs.
You begin to sing spiritual songs.
You begin
spiritually minded.
Yes,
singing and doing what?
Making melody. In your heart to the Lord.
You will not make melody to please people. Your melody will be to the Lord. In your heart, you will be worshiping God. You will not be singing the song that will make people to want to come and video you. Your songs will be to the Father. You worship Him. The Bible says God is His spirit, and they that worship Him must worship Him in spirit and in truth. Child of God, I ask you again, which ghost is in you? God put singing. Which ghost is in you? Who is giving you the song that you are singing? Holy Ghost cannot give you song about money.
No way.
When you find yourself singing song about bless, He bless me, He bless me, He make me to feel like sugar, love, love, love. He is not in that song.
Yes,
you are singing from your flesh.
Yes.
Because you know that people want to hear fleshy songs.
Yes.
You want them to dash you money. You want to be popular with men. You want them to be inviting you everywhere. You want your picture to be in every single border. God sees the heart. God sees the heart, and nobody can deceive Him in the mighty name of Jesus. Are you full with this?
Verse 20.
Yes.
Giving thanks always for all
things unto God and the Father. The Bible says, when the Spirit of God is in you, you will know how to give thanks. You will not be murmuring. You will not be complaining. You will speak with thanksgiving. Your mouth will be filled with thanks. You will not go and change the color of your skin. You will not bleach your skin. You will not shave your eyebrow. You will not wear attachment. You will thank God. You will not enlarge your breast. Not enlarge your buttocks. Hey, Calabaya. You will not fix nails. Oh, is that God's putting up? How do you feel when you fix this? Because the Holy Ghost is in me. And whenever I'm lifting up my hands, and I have just a little increase of my nails, a little increase, the Lord will tell me, Inkechi, go and reduce your nails.
Yes.
You're worshiping me. You're representing me. I wonder how you, sister, your own is as long as this. My own is natural, very little. God would allow me. I thank God for how He's fathering me. I thank God for how He's training me. I am not a bastard. I'm not a bastard. Hey, I have a daddy God that is concerned about everything. And He sent me the spirit of truth who will guide me to all truth. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Open the book of Romans chapter 8 verse number 1. Romans chapter 8 verse 1. Romans chapter 8 verse number 1.
There is therefore now no condemnation.
The Bible says, therefore now,
no condemnation.
No condemnation.
To them which are in Christ Jesus.
That's how many people stop. People stop here. They say, there's no condemnation. I'm in Christ Jesus. What did God say?
Who walk not after the flesh?
There is a condition for people that will not be condemned.
Yes.
Who do not walk after the flesh?
But after the Spirit.
But after the Spirit. Look at the S. Is it small S or big S?
Capital letter S.
Who do not walk after what their body dictates? They don't please the world. They are not moved to go and watch all these sexy movies. They don't have time. They are motivated, inspired, charged, guided by the Holy Spirit. Only those who are walking by the Spirit of God are worthy not to be condemned. If you are walking by the flesh, you dress as you like, you drink alcohol, you watch naked girls. All of you watching the Big Brother and all those pornography, have you put some ways? Have you never seen Job chapter 31 verse 1?
Uh-huh.
Job 31:1. Look at Job. You think that to receive blessing from God, you are looking for double blessing. You think it is easy? Look at Job chapter 31, verse 1. Before you come to this passage, my son.
Job 31, verse 1.
What did Job say?
I made a covenant with my eye.
The Bible says, Job said, I have made covenant with my eye.
Why then should I think upon him?
I will never look at women.
Yes.
I will not look at the naked girls in Big Brother. Yes. I will not watch pornography. Yes. I will not pollute my eye. Yes. How many of you have made covenant with your eye? Yes. In case my eye has gone into covenant. Yes. Say, I enter covenant with my eye. Yes. My eye will not watch rubbish. Yes. My eye will not behold naked girls. Yes. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes. You cannot have the spirit of God in you and your eye doesn't have control.
Yes.
Your eye must be controlled by the Holy Spirit. Say, guide us into all, including what your eyes should watch, what your ears should hear.
Yes.
You cannot listen to secular music
as
a child of God.
Yes.
This global altar is for heaven-bound children of God. How many of you still want to go to heaven?
I
want to make heaven at last. This global altar. Jokers is for serious-minded Christians. Like I said, by the grace of God, we are going to continue on Friday.
Hey.
But we are going to pray today. How are you going to pray today?
Hey.
So I'll finish up Romans chapter 8. Romans chapter 8. Go
verse
to.
2.
Yes.
For the law of the spirit of life in Christ Jesus.
Yes.
Has made me free from the law of sin.
Law of sin and death. Law of sin and death. Why? Because you are obeying the law of the spirit.
That's right.
You are walking in the spirit.
That's right.
So I'm not under the law. You will be under the law if you don't walk in the spirit. If you don't walk in the spirit, you will be under the law. Go to verse 7, my son.
Verse 7.
Yes, sir.
Because the carnal mind is enmity.
The Bible says the carnal mind
is enmity against God.
Is God's permanent enemy.
But it is not subject to the law of God.
It's not for the law of God.
Neither indeed can be.
Yes, go to verse 8.
So then,
yes,
say that are in the flesh.
The Bible says when you are in the flesh,
cannot please God.
You can never ever please God. When you are walking in the flesh, you and God will be going in opposite direction. You can't please him. Anything you are doing, he's angry with you. Go to verse 14. You say you have the Holy Ghost.
For as many as are led by the Spirit of God.
The Bible says in verse 14 of Romans chapter 8.
For as many as are led by the Spirit of
you that say Spirit of God is in you, Holy Ghost is in you.
They are the sons of God.
If he is not the one leading you to open your breast, you're not his child. Anything you are doing, the Spirit of God must be one leading you to enter that business.
Yes,
when you find yourself consumed with a particular business, like this networking business, it consumes souls.
Yes.
If you're not careful, child of God, with this networking business that make you to bring people in, as they are coming in, you are increasing your own line is going up. If you are not careful, that business will ruin your life. Be careful for your grave, your craving for wealth. The Bible says anything you are doing, did you consult God before entering that business? Did God say that you should enter that business? God is talking to people that are running after business. He said, be careful of how you rush to get money. Proverbs 28. Proverbs 28, verses 20 and 22. Proverbs 28, verses 20 and 22. Makuri and Dalagalepo Kosundaya. Regelebo Kosunta Lagalibra Kaya. Rego Libra Kosundalagaya. Yes, sir. Proverbs 28, 20 and 22.
20 and 22.
Yes, sir.
A faithful man shall abound with blessings.
The Bible says a faithful man is a spiritual man.
That's right.
A faithful man is a man that has the Spirit of God in him. What did he say?
A faithful man shall abound with blessings.
He shall abound with blessings.
For he that maketh haste to be rich.
The Bible says when you rush to get money,
shall not be innocent.
You want to make it by force. You want to be a rich man, a rich woman. You want to control people with wealth. What is going to happen to you?
Shall not be innocent.
You will never be innocent. You'll be guilty. You will walk in the flesh. The Holy Ghost will leave you. You have grieved him. You have quenched him. He's out of your life. What is 22 saying?
Verse 22.
Yes, sir.
He that hateth to be rich.
The Bible says when you are rushing to be rich,
hard and evil are.
Your eye is not good. Your eye is evil. Yes.
And consider it not that poverty shall come.
God said as you are rushing to make money, poverty is waiting for you. Go with the deliver of the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Children of God, you are going to wait on God for the business to do.
Yes.
God must lead you before you go into pressure of a business, pressure to go and do IVF, pressure. Many people have entered pressure without being led by the Spirit of God and they lost their lives. They lost their destinies. The Spirit of God cannot lead you into error. God says he will lead you to truth. He will lead you to the right way to go. He will not go into error. Who are your friends? Who are you following? Who is leading you to God? the Bible says God must lead you to the people that you are going to sit under. When you have the Spirit of truth in you, not every preacher will excite you. You will not be easily deceived. When you have the Spirit of God inside of you and you are under an evil teacher, not like me, when I hear people that are preaching heresy, God will tell me, Doctor, get up and walk away.
Yes.
It doesn't matter who is there. No matter how popular the preacher is. God told me, test all spirits.
Yes.
Test them. Everybody has a spirit.
Yes.
Test what is ruling them. There's a spirit behind them. Test that spirit. Hakuni and Dalagalanda. And God will tell me, this one is not my child.
Yes.
I remember when I went for a program somewhere and God told me, look to your right, and I turned, I saw a sister. He said, that is my daughter.
Oh,
I love her.
Yes.
I don't know her before, but God said, that is my daughter. God Almighty can introduce friends to you.
Yes.
The Bible says evil communication corrupt good man. God can introduce business partners to you. God can tell you who to marry, who you should follow.
Yes.
God can tell you even who to buy something from.
Yes.
Because the people you buy something from, and at the end of the day, the thing becomes useless to you.
Yes.
When you have the Holy Ghost, you do not struggle. You don't suffer. Hey, I feel like continuing with the Holy Ghost. But we are going to pray. Hey, gala, gala, we are going to pray. Rabo Kosunda, yada, yada. I know you want to continue with the Holy Ghost. Hey! Raka, yada, baba. The Holy Ghost's power is moving just like a magnet. The Holy Ghost's power is moving just like a magnet. The Holy Ghost is moving just like a magnet. I don't know what I would do without the Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost is everything to me. Holy Ghost is my joy. Holy Ghost is my peace. Can you tell me to begin to pray? Whenever you are, begin to pray. Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost. Hey, the Spirit of the Living God. Hey, open your mouth wherever you are and begin to worship God. Thank Him for the Holy Ghost. Thank Him for the Holy Ghost. Open your mouth and thank God. Father, I give you praise for your Spirit of God. The Holy Ghost is the Spirit of God. The Holy Spirit is the Spirit of God. For calling the Holy Ghost the third person. I didn't see it in the Bible. I followed what they said. I followed religious people. To call the Holy Ghost number first. Hey, who gave me number? Who put him in number? Hey, Father, forgive me. Open your mouth and repent. If you don't repent of that heresy, if you don't repent of that lie, you are not making heaven. The Holy Ghost is the Spirit of God. He's not number one, number two, number three. The Holy Ghost is the Spirit of God. Hey, Kanaboko Shenya. Repent as your. Tell yourself, I repent. Tell the Lord, I repent. I ask for your mercy. I repent, Lord. Have mercy on me. I didn't know. Have mercy on me, Lord. Have mercy on me, Lord. Rakaleboko Shenya. Rakakaya Nabosaya. Hey, Kakagalata Nagaya. Hey, Jesus. Mighty name, we are praying. Say, Father, I need your spirit in me. Baptize me with fire. Open your mouth and cry. You need fire, child of God. You need fire. You need fire. You need fire. It's not for the demons. I need the fire. You need the fire. Cry to God. Father, baptize me. Baptize me. The Lord said before the fire will come, some of you have grieved me. Some of you have questioned me. We are going to repent. Child of God, let us repent. Everywhere we have grieved the Holy Ghost. Everyone that questioned him. We have removed the influence of the Holy Ghost in our lives. By our character. By what we are watching. By our relationships. By our sexual life. Everything that we did. And we quench the Holy Ghost. Lift your voice and cry to God. Our Father, I repent of my quenching the Holy Ghost, my grieving the Holy Ghost. Open your mouth and cry to God. Lord, I repent to God. I repent to God. I repent to God. I ask for your mercy. I ask for your mercy. I ask for your mercy. I have grieved you, Lord. I quenched you the other day. I got angry. I shouted. I was not about to shout. I was not about to get angry. And you left me. And I felt empty. You left me. I felt empty. Lord, I'm sorry, Lord. I'm sorry, Lord. I'm sorry, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. You are about to cry to God. Don't have the Holy Ghost. The Lord said, anyone operating with sin, the Holy Ghost cannot come. There is a process. There is repentance. You must repent. You must repent of sin before the Holy Ghost can come. You are keeping malice. You cannot have the Holy Ghost. You are living in bitterness. You cannot have the Holy Ghost. Everyone you know has offended you. If Jesus tarries, before you come on Friday, go and make peace. Make sure you go and make peace. Holy Ghost cannot enter where there is bitterness. He cannot enter where there is unforgiveness. He cannot enter where there is malice. Hey, Kalamoko Sundaya, lift your voice and cry to God. I say, Father, open my eyes to every hindrance, to my having the Holy Ghost, to my flowing in the Holy Ghost, like the living water. Open your mouth and cry to God. I am thirsty for you, Lord. I am thirsty for you, Lord. I am thirsty for you, Lord. Open your mouth and cry to God. I am thirsty for you, Lord. Every word that you must reconcile. Go and reconcile. Go and make peace. Lord, have mercy on me, Lord. As I go and reconcile, Lord, let the way be open for the Holy Ghost to come. It's a gift to me. It's a promise to me. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Amen. The Lord said, I gave you the Holy Ghost. You never preached to me for me one day. Nobody came to me through you. You wasted the Holy Ghost. You are going to cry to God. I say, Father, forgive me for not using the Holy Ghost to preach the gospel. Even my family, I never told them about you. Open your mouth and repent. Say, Father, give me another chance. Another chance. Another chance. Another chance. Open your mouth and cry. Another chance. Lord, I will preach your God. I will preach your God. I will speak the truth of God. I will speak your word. I didn't use the Holy Ghost as I should. I'm not able to match in my life. Father, Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. Give another chance. Another chance. Another With the Holy Ghost, the preacher God, the restore, not restore, my gift to God, the gift of God, of prophecy, the gift to God, of praying to God, I lost it to God. I never prayed in tongues, I have only prayed in English. I thought they would laugh at me, I don't know who will laugh at me, I refuse to pray in tongues. I was ashamed of the Holy Ghost, I was ashamed of the Holy Ghost, I did not pray in tongues, I did not pray in the Holy Ghost. I was ashamed, Lord. Have mercy on me. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. I've got to pray the last prayer. If Jesus tarries, please let us meet again on Friday. May the Lord preserve you and keep you in the power of the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus. You're going to pray one more prayer and say, Father. I didn't allow the Holy Ghost to comfort me.
I didn't allow the Holy Ghost to comfort me.
I looked for human beings to comfort me. And I fell into sin. Lord, have mercy on me. I didn't allow the Holy Ghost. I thought you could not comfort me. And I went to commit sin. I went to commit sin. I couldn't bear it. I couldn't endure. I went to commit fornication. I went to commit adultery. I did masturbation. Oh, Father, I went to human being to look for pity. I went to human being for consolation. I didn't use the gift of the Holy Ghost to comfort me. Lord, have mercy on me, Lord. Hey, Galagayanda, yeah. Oh, Boko Soka, yeah. Hey, Galagayanda, yeah. Rabo Kosek. Yeah.